NASCAR fans on board. I would be remiss if I didn't tell you that our race weekends in 2019 are the first weekend of May, May 3rd through the 5th, and the first weekend of October, October 4th through the 6th in 2019. And if you have any other questions about how to purchase tickets, you can visit doverspeedway.com for all your answers. We do have several bus tours in the summer that occur. We also have car clubs that come. So we actually had a Mustang club over the summer. So we had about 40 Mustangs on the track at one time here. So that was a neat experience for those guys. We also, every year we have believe it or not, a PT Cruiser club that comes on the track. So
what's the age in that?
So yeah, it wouldn't be much of a race if the Mustangs raced the PT Cruiser, but.
What about Harleys?
Somebody mentioned Harley motorcycle. We do have motorcycle clubs that visit as well. There are a couple Harley drivers, believe it or not, who would not go up on the track just for cautious purposes. But and as you can tell, we're still on pit road. So keep in mind, remember what I said, the number two qualifier picks stall number 40. This is how far back that man has to pit, right here. The number two qualifier picks lots of times pits the end stall just so he can assure himself that nobody will block him coming in. And it's just up to him to be able to maintain that 40 miles per hour speed on the way, all the way down the exit of pit road. As we're coming up here, coming up into turn three, you'll see the Monster Bridge where we were in earlier. And you also get a good view of the hotel again. And like I said, that's more than 500 rooms and it's the largest hotel in Delaware. We are fully booked a lot, actually, especially for NASCAR race weekends, even though the room rates are, believe it or not, $350 to $450 per night. For those asking about the cones, those are the cones over here. This bridge coming up ahead of us that looks similar to the Monster Bridge is our Turn 2 walkover bridge. If you are in the infield while track activity is going on, that is the only way to exit the facility. There is no pedestrian or automobile tunnel here at Dover, being an older facility.
You don't have a button. Make sure you can place the crowd.
Head to your apron.
No, we're not.
Several people have asked about ticket prices. They range for the Cup Series from our Sunday races from $50 to $95. And the most expensive seats are ones that we're right below now, the high ones at turn one and the high ones over there at turn four. And again, that's because you can see all of the track and you can see up and down pit road. And now we are gonna be on film for posterity here as we go around toward the front stretch. Hopefully she's ready. She is in the bright pink shirt there. Now we must remember, somebody on the bus must remember, we have to come back around and get her. So just someone needs to be assigned to that. On your left here is the start-finish line, if you didn't notice it before. And that's our front stretch gate. That front stretch gate and the back stretch gate, which we entered the track on, those are the only two gates to get onto the track. The building to the right is our care center. If there's a bad accident, drivers go there to get checked out before they are cleared to return to their RVs or our racing shops. It is mandated now if a car cannot continue onto the track after an accident, if it cannot be driven to the garage area, a driver has to go to the care center to be checked out for concussion symptoms and other forms of health issues. That's new as of last year, and that is in response mostly to the concussion epidemic that's been occurring in sporting events. Luckily, there was a question about driver fatalities here at Dover. Luckily, we have not had a driver fatality here. We'd like to maintain that record, obviously. We have had some bad crashes, though. If any of you are proficient in YouTube, if you want to look up Dover crash Logano, who is Joey Logano, is one of the star drivers here. He flipped over 7 times in a car in 2009, and it actually occurred almost directly underneath the Monster Bridge where you all were before. But he was, thanks to the compact way these cars are constructed now, he was able to walk away right into the ambulance, maybe just a couple bumps and bruises. A couple of you mentioned Pocono Raceway before. If any of you were watching that race earlier this summer, Bubba Wallace, who's another young star, had a really bad crash. He lost his brakes going about 150 miles per hour across a grassy area that is much bigger than this grassy area here, and he slammed into one of the safer barriers, and he was able to walk away with just a couple broken bones in his foot. You can go down pit road. So these safer